Welcome to the Pint Size Personalization Podcast, brought to you by Johnson Plastics Plus. In this podcast, we talk to the movers and shakers, the influencers and makers who bring personalization to life. We find out what makes them tick and how they became successful in what they do. Today, Kylie Lucas is talking with Sumita and Anuj Patel from Homebound Custom Decor. Kylie, take it away.
Hi, everybody. My name is Kylie Lucas with Johnson Plastics Plus, and I am so excited because today I am sitting down with the Patels from Homebound Custom Decor, and we're going to have a fun conversation about her small business, how she got started, and some fun tips she has on holiday sales and marketing. I cannot believe we are talking about holiday stuff already, but it will be here before we know it. So let's just jump right in. And if you guys can kind of just give me a quick overview of how you got started with Homebound Custom Decor, maybe how your name was brought about, that sort of thing.
Yeah, of course. Thank you so much for having us. I'm Sumita, and I'm here with my husband, Anuj, and together we own Homebound Custom Decor. We're based out of North Atlanta, so we're down in Georgia, and we really got started with our business about 4 to 5 years ago. So it was the summer of 2019. We weren't really looking to get into business per se. You know, we were working our corporate jobs, and I had gone to a really cute boutique and bought a set of stamped books that had, a nice decor message on it. And I brought it home, and, you know, just like a typical maker and crafter, Anuj said, well, I could have totally made that for you. And, you know, he got mad at how much money I spent. So he decided to make a set on his own, and they actually came out really, really good. So I ended up posting it on Facebook Marketplace just to see if anyone would be interested in purchasing a set. And before we knew it, we had close to 50 orders in the first week.
So wow.
We were meeting people locally in the parking lot of a Whole Foods, and, you know, they would pick up their orders from us. And so we did that for about a year. We, you know, evolved, and we ended up having our own website. We grew our social media. But it wasn't until the summer of 2020 that we actually purchased our first laser. And once we did that, that was a Glowforge Pro. We wanted to really introduce cutting boards, and we thought that it would be nice to have boards and books as, you know, our business model.
I've never had this.
Right.
Business was very strong, thankfully, to our social media marketing and the marketing techniques we used. We ended up purchasing the second Glowforge, and then we very quickly graduated to an industrial CO2.
I've got it. Let me work on it on my
own. Okay.
And so we have now the PM lasers. We've had those for 3 years now.
Why?
And we are actually up to our seventh laser. So we've expanded our business quite a bit, and we actually have now introduced UV printing as well.
Awesome. Okay, so just on that note, can you give any tips for getting started with your small business to other small business owners out there, or maybe ones that are thinking about starting a small business? And that could be marketing related. It could be anything, any hurdles you may have faced that you've learned from and want to give that advice to other small business owners.
Yeah, I can jump in here. And thanks, Kylie, for the interview. We're excited to chat with you guys. I think when you're thinking of starting out a small business, I think a lot of people get overwhelmed. I think when they think about how much work goes into it, all they need to do, what they need to buy, equipment, time, space, I think a lot of people get overwhelmed. Definitely take it step by step. Understand really what you want to do, what you want to accomplish, what items you want to focus on, what market you want to kind of go into as well, and take it day by day. Obviously a business will take time to build. So if you're not seeing results immediately within the first, you know, couple weeks, couple months, or even the first year, it's okay. Don't get discouraged, but just keep on chipping away and stay motivated, because the results will come based on the time you put into it.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. So now I'm going to kind of switch gears here a little bit. More for like the marketing side. Do you guys have any tips? Because obviously when you start a small business, you need to get your brand out in the eyes of your customers. Do you have any tips for that? Just getting started?
Yeah. So when we were first starting out, you know, we really didn't have much of a marketing budget or funds to have marketing. So we had to get really scrappy with the types of marketing that we were doing. And they were kind of twofold. So we wanted to dominate our local market. And we did that by, you know, venturing out, going to a lot of networking events, making sure that people that were local to us knew that we existed. Because at the end of the day, someone can't support you if they don't know about you.
Right.
So we, you know, the craft fairs, and we did Chamber of Commerce events. We did networking events. We took opportunities to sponsor the local sports team. Anything that would help get, you know, our name out there that was within our budget. We would definitely take advantage of those and leverage those opportunities. But then on the flip side, because we knew that we're not just limited to our local market, we also wanted to continue building our social media platform because there, you know, really the entire country is up for grabs and can support you if they know about you. So we were also simultaneously building that social media platform, you know, posting content consistently. So making sure people can see what you offer. You know, utilizing hashtags, especially on platforms like Instagram and TikTok, and then thinking a little outside, you know, the box as well. So not just using a hashtag for the item that you're posting, but if you're using the coasters that you guys sell, you know, thinking ahead of the game, what can people buy these coasters for? Typically, a warming gift or a closing gift. So using those hashtags would get the right customer in front of you. We did a lot of work with influencers as well, especially early on. We would send influencers our product, and if they liked it, they would be generous enough to post about it and then share it on their platform, which really drove a lot of sales to us as well.
Yeah, very, very cool. So you mentioned the coasters. Can you kind of talk a little bit about, I know we talked about marketing for tumblers, the coasters, leather materialed items, anything like that. What kind of marketing strategies do you have for those items? It may be social media. I know you said using the hashtags, using maybe what this item could be used for outside of what the item actually is. What about tumblers? How do you usually go about your marketing strategies for that?
Yes, so the tumblers are actually one of our more popular items. The ones we get from you guys are definitely the 20-ounce, the 30-ounce, and the one with handles as well. You know, especially with tumblers, we've realized there's a lot of local business as well. Whether you are a corporation or another small business or a boutique, everyone loves to have a good tumbler on hand. And I think it goes a long way when you can put some kind of custom engraving on there. It just elevates that experience for that person. Now they're not just holding a regular day-to-day tumbler. It's a tumbler with their name on it, or a design, or their kids' names, or something. That's kind of how we used to our go-to-market with tumblers. Like I said, every single business would use them for promotional items for themselves. So we've had businesses buy them for their entire, their staff, for their corporation. We've had doctor's offices buy them for their small staff. We've also worked with a lot of local high schools as well that want to support their local teams, you know, to give them some drinkware. But it's a really great opportunity. And like I said, I think the customization, we're seeing that trend. It's just continuing to go upwards. And one thing that people carry the most is tumblers. They have it in their car. They take it to work. They take it to the grocery store. So it's a lot of guerrilla marketing per se. When people go around, they carry our engraved tumbler. And the question they get is, hey, where did you get that from? Or, hey, that's a really cool tumbler. Can you give me more info? And they usually pass along our business. And we'll get a lot of, you know, it's they got your contact information. So and so, I saw they had a Tumblr. They gave me your card. I'd like to order some as well.
Oh yeah.
So use tumblers for you know, kind of going back to the marketing strategy that we use for it, using that as the item to kind of get in the door with a lot of local businesses. So when we were trying to network, we would just take them one tumbler. You know, you guys have them priced so affordably that it was a great opportunity for us to just take a tumbler, pull their logo, engrave it, and then now when we're stopping by to try to do with them, we're not just introducing ourselves.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, that's really cool. What are some other items that you often find that you are kind of making for these businesses? You might start out with the tumbler, but are you doing other items that are highly in demand with these businesses too that you'd like to share?
Yeah, I think ornaments are another great thing, especially the leatherette, you know, shaped ornaments, or you could even use just a round leatherette patch, but that's something that's relatively inexpensive. But again, you could pull their logo or maybe, you know, something that is unique to them. Maybe they have a slogan or a motto that would, you know, fit well on the ornament. And that's something that you could always engrave. Or actually UV print and even sometimes sublimate and then hand out to them. And again, it's just that added touch that you took that extra step and you went the extra mile to try to earn their business. You're not just dropping off a business card, but you're actually dropping off something that's personal to them.
And I think to kind of piggyback off what Sumita mentioned, the ornaments are obviously very super popular around the holidays now. We recently just got a portable laser. So we've been starting to go to a little bit more shows and events. And I always describe it to people as when you go to Disney World, everyone buys an ornament and get your names around there for your families. And there's always a line you have to go pick it up later on. So for us, taking those engravable ornaments or even the coasters and having a booth on site, having someone come up and say, oh, I can get this design and you can put my last name on it, you can put my family's and you can put my kid's name. I think it goes a long way. And they love to see the experience of, oh, wow, it's engraving right in front of me on site, and I get to take it home my tree. I think it adds a lot of value.
Yeah, absolutely. So I know you guys kind of mentioned ornaments and the holidays. So the holidays are quickly approaching. So do you have any like holiday sales tips maybe for businesses that this might be their first holiday season? It's a pretty busy time. I'm sure you guys are already seeing that, even in the beginning of October. Do you guys have any tips for navigating the holiday season for someone who's maybe only a year into their business or maybe have not started yet, but are kind of fearful of what that could look like just because of how busy?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. I think the holidays, the biggest thing that for me specifically is just prepare yourself. Make sure you do your inventory checks. Make sure you're stocking up on enough items. You guys do a great job with inventory and getting stuff shipped out pretty quickly. I would do that. If you're doing kind of specific holiday designs, have those designed in advance and make it easy for yourself. So if you're doing a Christmas tree with people's names on it, set up your file, whether it's an Illustrator or any other software you're using, have the design ready to go, maybe have some text boxes so it's easy for you to just drop that in versus having to do stuff on the fly. But I would have a couple good different designs ready to go for the holidays and different things. Maybe you can do something with tumblers, coasters or boards or leatherette items. But I would say definitely be prepared and kind of making sure you have your inventory ready to go because it will come around pretty quickly and it'll get you before you know it.
Yeah.
I think another important piece is, you know, making sure that you're choosing products, like Anuj said, you can easily source because the last thing you want to do is introduce an item and then you're stuck not being able to source them. So for us, we do like to stick with suppliers, you know, like Johnson's Plastics that consistently have, you know, sourcing and we never have to worry about an item usually going out of stock. So that's important, but then also choosing products that are easily, you know, personalizable and you don't have to spend tons of time on it because the idea is that during the next 60 days at the end of Q4, you are the busiest that you will be. And so you don't want to introduce products that are very time consuming or cumbersome. You want to pick products that are very efficient and that have a higher profit margin, but less, you know, time invested in the product. So we're very mindful of, you know, what we introduce during this time, because again, we don't want to spend an hour working on one ornament when we could instead be utilizing that hour cranking out, you know, five of a different product.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Is there anything else you guys would like to touch on as far as your small business or anything holiday related as we kind of wrap up here?
One piece of advice I always like to share is, it can get really tempting, especially when we're in the maker space and we have the ability to make everything. Just because we can make everything doesn't always necessarily mean that we should, or it may not be a good fit for our business. So model that we've kind of strived for is, you know, overall our tagline is personalized gifts and goods. And before we try to introduce a new item, we really make sure, is this something that You know, our average customer, which happens to, you know, typically be a female between the ages of 18 to 55, is this something that they would utilize at least once or twice as a gift in the course of their typical social life? So we try to cover occasions like housewarmings and weddings, birthdays, baby showers. We try to make sure we have an item available or at least a couple of items available for each of those occasions. And we have found that that's been a good strategy for us because it means that we will have consistent business year round and we're not just waiting for the next holiday.
Right.
That's been a strategy that's worked well. And we kind of become the go-to gifting destination for your customers. So we have a high customer return rate, which shows that they can rely on us for, you know, their gifting needs.
Yeah.
I think for me, it's two things. Slow down where you can. It definitely gets fast and fierce. And I feel like burnout happens a lot because people are just so overwhelmed. They're inundated with orders left and right. And I think the second thing is it's okay to say no. If you are getting hit with, you know, so many different, you know, custom pieces and orders, and if you set a deadline and your deadline is to be done a week before Christmas or 2 weeks, you are going to get people that are going to come to you and say, can I just get a last minute item? Or I forgot to add this. It's okay to say no, because like, it's very easy to get overwhelmed, get burnt out and get stressed out. And then I guess I add one more thing. It's okay to outsource some stuff too. We, you know, by trade are not file designers at all. We will support other makers. So if there is something complicated that we can't figure out or that we want to launch and we can't do on our own, you know, it's okay to ask other people in this space. There's a big community presence here that everyone kind of supports each other. So ask for help. If it's a large order, maybe you may be able to take on, but you need some extra support with, reach out to another maker locally or see who's close by and see how they can support you as well.
Yeah, I really like how you mentioned that because we're all kind of in this together, and in the maker space, everyone, we can kind of work together and make things happen for each other. So I really like how you mentioned that. Is there anything else you guys would like to add for today?
No, not out.
No.
Just want to say thank you to you. And you know, to the rest of the team at Johnson's Plastics, we've really enjoyed all of the products that we use, and they have really proven to be quality and you know, provide a great profit margin for us. They're some of our top sellers on our website.
Yeah, wonderful. Yeah, we've really been happy to have you guys. You provided a lot of great tips, marketing tips, and with the holiday season coming up, I think this is really good advice for small business owners that may have just gotten started, have been for a while, or anyone looking to start their small business. It's definitely a fun industry. So, yeah.
Yeah, awesome.
All right. Well, we're happy to have you guys, and we look forward to talking to you again soon.
Thank you. Bye.
You've been listening to the Pint Size Personalization Podcast with your host, Kylie Lucas, brought to you by Johnson Plastics Plus. Please remember to like and subscribe to this podcast wherever you get your podcasts. And for more information on the thousands of customizable products we have available, visit jpplus.com.